Lightning reporter and radio analyst Caley Chelios joining us right now. Caley, the Lightning, we know this team can put up the goals, but the offense has kind of surged the last couple of games. 38 goals their last seven games. What's kind of led to that offensive surge?
Yeah, and they've had four or more goals in their last seven consecutive games. They lead the league with 151, 11 ahead of Toronto right now. So, I mean, they stay on top of the puck. They're so dangerous when they get into the offensive zone, and they like to establish their forecheck early on. And when they get things going, they're playing with pace and they're playing with speed. They're a really challenging team to beat. It's not just the top two lines, or even if you can say top two anymore, it's all four lines that find ways to contribute every night. That fourth line obviously was imperative in that game against Vancouver midway through the trip. And we've seen obviously what Stamkos and Nikita Kucherov, two elite goal scorers in this league, can do when they're feeling confident and when they're on a run right now. So this team has obviously been led by their goal scoring. They've been able to score their way out of some games where they haven't defended as well as they'd like to. I think that's one area of their game that they'd like to continue to work on, especially coming out of this road trip. I think they managed that game defensively consistently. I think the best they have yet against Edmonton. And for all the narratives that probably went against them going into that game, they did a really nice job. I mean, it was the last game of a really tough road stand. Oilers had a couple days off to practice and recharge. They were coming off back-to-back losses, and yet the Lightning were able to score six goals, but yet I think defensively that was arguably their best game. And to have that at the end of the road trip kind of says where this team is at as far as their compete and their mentality right now.
You mentioned the Bolts, a tough team to beat. Nobody's been able to do it in regulation this month. They have a chance to finish the month of December without a regulation loss. What's kind of been the key to their success during this whole month?
I think they like the way that they're skating, the way that they start games. They've come out really energized, and you know, they're not complacent right now. I know it's easy to kind of sit back and look at where they are in the standings with kind of the lead that they've been able to build, but they're coming out there just as hungry and just as competitive. Obviously, they put themselves in a really good position to be successful, but the depth on this team has time and time again been a huge reason for their success. Andre Vasilevsky coming back in the mix, even though Louis Domingue was outstanding in his absence. If it's not their, you know, top six doing it, it's Vasilevsky. If it's not Vasilevsky, sometimes it's their special teams right now. They're finding ways to win. They're finding different ways to score every night, which has probably been the most remarkable thing. And, of course, you have Nikita Kucherov, Steven Stamkos, and Tyler Johnson, just lots of players offensively getting to that 20-goal mark right now and just kind of distributing the wealth on all four lines.
You mentioned special teams, number one power play unit in the league, top 10 on the PK as well. So who's been the catalyst for both special teams that makes it really click here for Tampa?
They have a lot of different options, and it's not just that top power play group. I mean, John Cooper had talked last season and this season about how having two effective power play units has been tremendous for them. And on their second one, you have Mikhail Sergachev kind of quarterbacking that one. And although some of his play doesn't show up on the score sheet, he's really a driving force for them offensively. And when you have Stamkos, Nikita Kucherov, and then Victor Hedman kind of lined up like that, I mean, teams don't know how to defend, whether it's Braden Point some games just kind of getting that tap in from Kucherov. And then, of course, both the circles are just so dangerous on either flank. So they've been unstoppable right now. And when players like Steven Stamkos, just a pure goal scorer, has confidence, and he's shooting, and you're seeing what he's seeing every night. I mean, from his knees, he's getting those one-timers in. It's pretty challenging for any goaltender to stop, and the only way teams have been able to have success is when they really pressure them, you know, put that high-pressured penalty kill and try to get them on their heels a little bit coming into the zone. So I know Philadelphia has had some success with their penalty kill in their last 14 games or so, but they struggled early on, so it should be a pretty good test. You know, the Philadelphia Flyers, they don't have the best power play either, but against the Lightning, I think they had two or three goals come in the third period of their last meeting in Philadelphia for that big comeback.
All right. We'll have to see how it plays out tonight. The Bolts, perfect so far in regulation this month. Caley, thank you very much. Enjoy the game tonight.